friends, here we are in our YouTube studio,
aka the dining room.
Well, we have to work with what we have, right? So it's a cold, blustery day in March in Ohio.
We thought we would share with you some of our favorite places in Alaska, places we visited and absolutely loved. Many people only get to go to Alaska one time, if they even get to go at all, and it's a bucket list trip for many people. So we've been very blessed to be there several times.
Quite a few.
Yeah, quite a few times.
So we have compiled our own list. I don't know what's on her list. She doesn't know what's on mine, of our top five spots. We're going to go in reverse order. I thought anyone that goes to Alaska, you always have two things you always want to see. Denali and the Northern Lights. I did not include that in my list. Caveat. So what we're going to do is say number five at the same time and then explain why. You ready?
Count down to number one on the list, right?
To number one on the list. Plus, there's going to be two honorable mentions at the end. So,
and a bonus question.
Yeah, there's a question coming. Don't know what it is. So hopefully this might be filtered.
Are you ready? So number five on
your
list.
In 3, 2, 1.
Hatchet Pass.
Oh, no.
What'd you say?
Girdwood.
Girdwood?
Yes.
Really?
Girdwood put at the last of your list. There's a reason for that. You have the Nordic Spa.
Yeah.
You can go relax. You can go to Chair 5 for some really yummy pizza, deep dish, delicious. You can go to AWCC, the Alaska Wildlife Conservation Center.
But that's not in Girdwood.
That's close enough.
Okay.
The vicinity. Look, Alaska's huge. Texas, sorry, you're pretty small, relatively speaking.
Alaska's bigger than Texas, California, and Montana combined. Did you know that?
Yes, maybe you could drop in a picture of it. So that is why I said that. You also have hiking. You can take, if it's winter, you can go skiing, or you can take the tram up to the top. There's all sorts of stuff you can do in Girdwood.
And there's Alyeska.
Right, Alyeska's in
Resort
Girdwood.
Resort Alyeska, which smells delightful. And we actually have a candle that smells just like Alyeska.
Why did you put Hatcher Pass number five?
I put Hatcher Pass at number five because Hatcher Pass has a lot of history.
Okay.
It has a lot of hiking, beautiful landscapes, wonderful for photography, just absolutely breathtaking. But there were some other places that I like more.
All right. Full disclosure, what's your favorite thing to do when we go to Alaska?
Go to Kalati Brothers Coffee.
Take photographs?
I'll take photos, yes.
Okay. Mine is just to go hike.
Okay.
So we should have caveated that. All right. You ready to go to the next one?
All right. Drum roll.
What do you got?
Gotta get through 3, 2, 1.
3, 2, 1.
Valdez. Richardson Highway.
Ah! Oh.
What did I say? Richardson Highway. That's what I said.
And Valdez. Yeah.
But it's the same thing.
Well, okay.
So it's not Valdez proper. It's the road to get to Valdez that is so beautiful. And I think maybe we probably like the same things. Thompson Pass, right?
Yeah.
The road to get to Valdez. So going down the Richardson Highway, you go through Glacier View, through Glen Allen, the Wrangell Mountains, which are spectacular. You go through Nelchina with all the trees, all the spruce trees.
Lake Louise.
In the fall is absolutely gorgeous. And then going down the Richardson Highway, well, that's the Glen Highway, but then going down the Richardson Highway, you go through Thompson Pass, and then you get to Valdez, and it's like all the waterfalls. It's like being in a tropical rainforest.
You get to see volcanoes on the way down.
Yeah.
When you go to Valdez, yes, you can go to hatcheries, other places, but the special thing about the hatchery there are
the bears.
The bears. So you can go see bears. Be safe. Don't be foolish. Don't be a typical tourist trying to get a picture or selfie with the bear 3 feet away.
And well, you didn't do the selfie, but you did get out of the car and go try to get a closer picture.
I had the car between me and the bear, and it was eating fish. And I had the door open, so... kayaking, be very careful if you go to
the glacier.
There's boats and lots of good food, and the people are super nice there too.
They are. It's a great place. It's definitely worth the trip. It's a long trip. It's what, 5 hours from Anchorage, I think, on a normal drive, but it took us probably all day. So
I'm curious, what's your number three?
Are we on number three?
We're
already
on number three.
What's my number three? You'll be surprised.
What is it?
Seward.
At number three,
uh-huh,
I had Thompson Pass. So we just talked about the
okay.
They're different places.
Okay.
So Thompson Pass, since you love photography so much, you literally can drop your camera and take a beautiful picture.
It is
go
perfect.
See it in the fall. Gorgeous. And you just kind of keep hiking and hiking. I think there's a camping area close there, too, if you camp. We did not have the gear to go camping at that point. But you go up and you keep going and you look over the cliff and you're like, wow. And it just keeps going and going and going. And what's it known for in the wintertime?
The snow. Lots and lots of snow.
And snow machining.
And snow machining.
Tons of...
Well, they do open the road, I guess. It's closed. I don't really know all the rules of when the roads are closed and not closed. And because they get a lot of snow.
Yep, they do. All right, why'd you put Seward at three?
I put Seward at number three because, well, I love Seward, first of all. It's my favorite town in Alaska. And, of course, Resurrection Bay.
Good.
The road to get to Seward, there are so many. It's another beautiful drive. Almost as beautiful as the drive to Valdez. Not
okay.
quite, in my opinion.
Okay.
Maybe pretty equal. But the road to get to Seward, there's lots of stops along the way. That's where I include Alyeska, the...
you can't
that's
say...
That's not part of Seward, but that's Gardwick. But the
you're doing, like, this destination in a 100-mile radius. Not allowed.
Pretty much. So, Resurrection Bay, clearly,
okay.
is my favorite part. And Lowell Point Beach is my favorite little beach and favorite little spot in Seward. We went fishing there last time mm-hmm. we were there. Had a blast, salmon fishing, had a great captain at Miller's Landing, did a great job.
Two thumbs up.
Yeah, for sure. So, love the town, love the people, love everything about Seward.
All right.
Except maybe the rain. There's a lot of rain there. But there's a lot of rain in Alaska anyway, so.
No bad weather, just bad
gear.
Bad gear.
Yeah.
Go prepared. All right, number two. We're getting through this list pretty quick.
We are.
3, 2, 1.
Glacier Bay.
Ooh.
You forgot Glacier Bay, didn't you?
I did forget Glacier Bay.
And I say Glacier Bay and all glaciers.
So the state of Alaska is her favorite.
So, well, just glaciers.
Yeah.
And I figured I have to give it a destination, but the glaciers of Alaska are fascinating, and we've seen them by boat, we've seen them by air, and we've walked on them one several times, or a couple of times. Oh, by helicopter. We saw mm-hmm. by helicopter. Amazing in every way that you see them. And just so much. And just the ice and the blue of the glaciers is amazing. You can see them calving. Just gorgeous. It's absolutely gorgeous. So, yeah. And Glacier Bay, being surrounded by them on our cruise, was breathtaking.
I said Seward because there's so much to do. You said fishing. You have kayaking.
Mm-hmm.
You have sea otters, which actually is one of my favorite animals. You have Exit Glacier. Fantastic mm-hmm. hike. Do it. Do it. What?
Not just the Exit Glacier, but the Harding Ice Field.
The Exit Glacier will hike all the way to the top so you can see the Harding Ice Field. So... get in shape, but do it. What else? Oh, you have the Sea Life Center.
Mm-hmm.
It's quaint. They have wonderful custard, lots of little shops, right? It's a good place to spend some time. Do you have dog sledding?
Mm-hmm.
What else?
Oh, yeah. The Seaweed's dog. I did a ride is there. That's fun.
Yeah. So, I mean, like, there's something for everyone in Seward.
And you can drive down Lowell Point Road and go to Lowell Point Beach, which is fun.
The road's a little sketchy. Go back a couple of years, it may or may not have wiped out.
Yeah. big rock slide, landslide
there. Big rock slide. So you do need to be careful. Follow the rules.
Don't stop. Just keep going.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. Good advice. The other thing, no matter where you go, whether it's hiking, just wherever, whatever you take with you, bring back. And if you find trash, pick it up. Animals don't need it. They need to be flying around.
Sadly, all right. People leave trash laying around, which I can't stand. But
now I'm curious to what your number one's going to be.
Seriously?
Well, you put Seward at 3.
What do I love the most about Alaska?
I know what your number one is.
So, ready? 3, 2, 1.
3, 2, 1.
Denali.
I caveated at the beginning that Denali and Northern Lights are a must. I actually had Hatcher Pass.
As your number one. That doesn't surprise me.
Hatcher Pass is my number one because it is like a playground. When I see Hatcher Pass, I've been able to do one of the things I always wanted to do, which is walk the ridgeline. Wasn't a mountain, but we did gain.
There are mountains there.
We gained like 1,000 feet. We gained 1,000 feet in 0.8 miles with my nieces, and we walked the ridgeline. We had an interesting way to come down, but that's another story. But just the number of hikes, the things that
they
you can do.
They slid down the mountain.
Fog was rolling in. You got to go prepared, and sometimes you just have to take an alternate route. But we were safe. We spread out. We had our bear song going. We had bear spray with us. We had air horns. So I think we were good. Pack lunch, pack breakfast. You can blueberry pick. Lots of history. You can pan for gold. I think you can paraglide there, too. Oh, pikas. They have pikas.
All the pikas. They're so cute. So Denali, I don't think you can compare Hatcher Pass with Denali. I mean, come on. It's Denali. It's the biggest
Denali's
mountain
given.
Technically in the world.
So from base to top, relative to Everest, because they have different elevations that they start at, what's the difference? Do you recall?
1,000 feet, I think.
A mile. I thought it was a mile. We're going to have to fact check that.
I don't know.
We'll check Dr. Google.
I don't know. Don't ask me hard questions on the camera.
It's fine.
So it's not just Denali, right? It's Denali National Park as well.
Still but in the park.
Lots of animals, wildlife. We saw tons of wildlife when we took the bus trip, and there's only one road in and out, and you can only drive in a car so far, and then you have to take a bus in. Totally worth it. If you ever ask yourself, should I take the bus? So Polychrome Pass, the road got wiped out. Another situation with a landslide. So people ask online a lot, you know, should I still take the bus trip? Yes, you should still. It's beautiful. It's breathtaking. And if you get to the chance to see Denali, you're one of the 30% that actually get to see it. Unbelievable. And it's one of those things that when you look up and you see for the first time, it literally takes your breath away. Yeah. And there's nothing in Alaska that can compare to it.
That's true. What do you have for, so that's our top five each. Very similar, different order. What did you have for honorable mentions?
Honorable mentions were the Northern Lights and winter in Alaska.
Okay. So I had Chena Hot Springs, but you're right. It has to be in the winter. Chena Hot Springs. Take your bathing suit, you walk out, you're freezing, you're like, this is insane. And then you get into the hot spring, and you're like, it's hot in here after a few minutes. The trees were, we went in what, February?
Uh-huh.
The trees were the Dr. Seuss trees, right, covered with snow, kind of bent over a little bit at the top.
Frosty, and because of the steam that's coming off the water.
You can go to the ice sculptures. I think you can go dog sledding up there, too.
Mm-hmm. The ice museum.
Ice museum, too.
Mm-hmm.
So.
You have a martini in an ice glass.
And you break the ice glass after.
Yeah.
So.
So I said, go ahead.
Oh, go ahead.
I said the Northern Lights because, again, Denali and the Northern Lights. There's two things about Alaska that nothing can compare. When you see the Northern Lights, it's awesome is a good word to use, right?
Pretty amazing.
Just, yeah.
So when you see the Northern Lights too, at least our experience was they were, the sky was dancing and dazzling for like an hour and a half. It just, you could lay on your back and from horizon to horizon, the sky was just filled.
So. And the stars were really pretty too. And we saw those on our property.
We did.
Which was really cool.
We did.
And so hopefully we'll get to see lots of those. But that, and then what's the other thing? Oh, winter in Alaska. So it's just magical. I mean, it looks like Narnia. And I specifically was thinking about the railroad, Alaska railroad trip that we took. And just going through the backcountry on the train. And just absolutely magical. It was so pretty. And you could just sit there and stare out that window on that train. I did for hours. And it was so pretty.
And people were spotting moose. They saw lynx.
We saw like 30 moose.
It was actually like at least 40. More than 40. We stopped counting then. But yeah, the train is definitely worth it as well. And I had one other thing, and you mentioned it a little bit already in some of your 100-mile radius destinations. And it was this. Instead of think of, it's enjoy the drive. Instead of thinking of, oh, we got to get to this destination, think of exploration. Mm-hmm. Because there are so many wonderful spots. Like, take your time getting there. It's worth it. Don't just go to Alaska to visit it. Go to Alaska to experience it. And so there's a little hidden spot we talk about. It's close to Alaska Wildlife Conservation Center. It's on Portage Road, mile marker 2.
Don't tell them.
I know. Everyone will be there. It'll be
great. Where our secret spot is.
But you go there, and it's a black sand beach, pond, whatever. But it's glacier fed. And so on a nice summer day, if you're blessed with the sun out, even if it isn't, still do this. You sit down on the black rocks and it's warm and take your socks and shoes off and put your feet in the water.
Yeah.
That's fun.
It's like fun.
You get to experience it and be in it. And then there's several glaciers on down. You have all the way further down the road, you have Byron Glacier, which is a nice mile and a half out there.
From up there.
Yeah, you have several glaciers
up there. Yeah.
That's right.
There's a little picnic table there. The water, I've been there, I don't know, 3 times now, 4 times now or something, and it's can be anywhere from aqua to like emerald green. It's beautiful. But sparkly with the sun on it.
Yeah. That would be my advice. Wherever you go, depending on what you want to see or experience, just enjoy that drive. There is a lot of people that sometimes they're not sure. The roads are fine. They're not sure, so they'll go with a tour agency. Nothing against tour agencies, but my preference is take your time, because people would get out and they go click, 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 and gone.
Yeah, they have 5 minutes to just get their pictures, whatever, and then back on the bus and go. Like, no, you have to experience it.
Yeah.
And Alaska is so huge. You can't really know how big it is until you get there. I mean, it's going to take you longer than you ever think it's going to take you to get from point A to point B, just because there's so many places to stop.
Yeah. I mean, and we've gone down roads and we're like, wait, what's that over there? And we saw beluga whales on our way to Hope. Yeah. So there's, again, enjoy the drive. Think exploration, not just destination. Take your time. There's great food, great people.
Sure.
The wonderful people coffee. Wonderful. And
I love the
people. Enjoy the experience.
People are fun. We've been from Fairbanks to Valdez to all the way down to Homer, over to Denali, up to, not Haynes.
Haley. Healy.
Healy. And everywhere in between. So we've traveled quite a bit.
But when you look at the map,
it's really not when you
still
look at,
a lot more.
Compare it, right,
to the state. What's your question?
The bonus question is, okay, what is your favorite animal? What, I think you already said it, but what's the animal you get most excited when you see it?
Any animal in its natural habitat. However, I did already say I love sea otters, and I specifically love the picture. We went out on a boat ride when we were in Homer, went over to Saldovia. Tim took us, and there was a mama with her baby still on her chest, and it was still holding on.
That was really sweet.
They're cute.
Well, since I've never seen a wolf in the wild, it would be a wolf, hands down. But I can't say that because I haven't seen one other than in captivity.
Cool.
I would say it's whales.
Yeah. Which type?
The
orca,
humpback whales. Yeah.
Oh, tell them about what we saw when we went fishing.
Seeing them, first of all, seeing them breach. We saw that in Juneau when we went whale watching, and that was pretty cool. But then we saw them bubble net feeding.
We saw in Resurrection Bay too. Right before they were bubble net feeding.
Okay.
I got it on video.
Yeah, we did. We got to see them bubble net feeding, which was so cool to get to see that, about 12 of them at the same time.
All these, if you don't know what bubble net feeding is, the whales will work together. They form a net out of bubbles, and it stuns the fish. And what happens is they bring that net in closer, it brings those fish in closer, and then they synchronize and come up through the middle of the mouths open.
Take a big gulp of fish.
So. Maybe we can get a screenshot of the video and show the mouths.
Yeah.
That was fun.
It was cool. It was pretty cool.
That's some National Geographic stuff.
It is.
According to the captain, and I think he was right.
Well, good. Well, I hope that about covers it, right?
I think that covers it, but want to hear from you. Are you going? Do you plan to go? Have you been? What are some of your top spots?
Yeah.
Comment below. Thanks.
Or if you have any secret spots, tell us.
Other than Mighty Marker 2.
Ours. Well, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. We appreciate you guys.
Bye.
See ya.